waiting, wearing something or not. Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm Lauren, if you're new here, and today is episode 4 of Vlogmas. Let's talk about flirting while married. First rule of thumb, never let them find out. Just kidding, it's not that kind of video. I don't know if that's what you think by the title, but that's not what this video is about. It's about flirting with your spouse, with your mate. Have you ever been thinking about marriage, or have you ever had a conversation about marriage and someone says that the spark will die off, it's inevitable? Kick them in the face, right there, right then, just kick them square in the face. I was told this, and I'm still told this, and I'm married, all the time. But there have been a few rare times where a married couple, a happily married couple, will tell me that that is not true and that it does not have to be the case. I was skeptical because that is opposite of what most people say. But then I sat back and I was thinking about who was telling me which advice. Most of the people who were telling me the spark was gonna die off were the couples where the spark did die off, or people who weren't even in a relationship. But this couple who told me that the spark doesn't have to die off were happily married, and not just happily married. They'd been married for years and years and years. So I kept listening. Those who told me that they were still infatuated with one another, that they were still obsessed with each other, well, I wanted that because obviously their relationship was healthy and happy, which is what I'm assuming most people want. Without telling you too much of my backstory of love, which that can be a whole nother video, I will try to give you a very, very shortened version. Before marrying Adam, I had a few different relationships. I even almost got married to someone else several years back. So I had convinced myself, again, this is pre-Adam and I, that relationships were just meant to function. That the aim and goal of marriage was to survive and function. I had thrown out the idea of thriving and certainly thrown out the idea of forever being in love. I figured because it dies off anyway, why have it in the first place to begin with? See, I had my heart broken when I was really young. I was in love, I was head over heels. Fast forward and my heart was shattered. Fast forward several more years and I was in another relationship. And this time, I was not in love head over heels fairy tale kind of love. I told myself that that kind of relationship ends in pain, is toxic, and no good. But this time, at least this guy was my best friend in the whole world. We did everything together. But that fairy tale love just wasn't there. And guess what? It ended in pain. So then I wrote off being best friends with the person you're with as toxic, painful, and no good. Fast forward again, and I decided that functionality was where it's at. Nobody gets hurt, no highs, no lows. But I was so wrong, and obviously that relationship didn't last. But it took a lot for me to realize that the coaching I had done, you know, things I had taught myself, spoken over myself, things I had heard were wrong. Love is supposed to be a fairy tale, and they are supposed to be your best friend. Yes, you may argue from time to time, and yes, you can have other friends, even best friends. But the advice to enjoy the honeymoon phase while it lasts is totally bogus. Adam and I still joke about how we were told when we first started dating that the honeymoon phase lasts about 3 months, so after 3 months, you'll really know what your relationship is. Well, 3 months passed, we got engaged, more months passed, we got married, and now we're coming up on a year of being married. The honeymoon phase has not passed. And I realize it's only coming up on a year, and there'll be some grumpy people watching this being like, yeah, but you haven't been married for 3, 4, 50 years. Well, I'm sorry you feel that way. But let's get to it, shall we? Trust me when I say flirting is mutually beneficial. Flirting is freaking fun. And flirting may mean something different to you than it does to me. I kind of think of flirting as the joking around, being silly, and ending up laughing hysterically. Romancing, on the other hand, is the kind of flirting where you hold hands, you look into each other's eyes, and you reminisce about how you fell in love and how it all took place. Which, let me say, I highly recommend doing that. That's actually one of my biggest tips for people, especially when they first get married, or really in any relationship at any point, is to never stop talking about how it all went down. Trust me, you will keep discovering more and more aspects of the story, or things you may have forgotten. It's so fun to just retrace those beginning steps. However, flirting, to me, is speaking in different accents, making funny faces, and twerking on each other. I feel like if you lose your sense of fun, then yeah, you may temporarily lose that spark, but that's on you, not on the relationship. I will say intentionality is so important to keep that spark healthy and happy. Writing love notes when you feel like it, when you don't, cleaning the house for each other, doing little things like cooking or cleaning or waiting, wearing something or not. leave those love notes places that they'll find later when you're not there. Oh, in texting. Adam and I spent some time when we first started dating being long distance. And oh my word, the love texts that we sent each other would either make you swoon or want to throw up. Luckily for us, they made us swoon. But now we see each other all the time. But it's still fun to text while he's working or he texts while I'm working, little sweet nothings. Oh, you know what else is kind of steamy? Texting each other while you're in the same room, like with other people in the room. We've done that a lot. It feels sneaky and cute and fun. Highly recommend. Keep things spontaneous. Dance in the kitchen, whisper something sweet, and don't forget to kiss. When I come home, he greets me with a hug and kiss. Or when he comes home, I greet him with a hug and kiss. Sometimes I am super hard in the paint editing a video, but I really try to stop what I'm doing and make him feel like he was missed when he was gone and welcome home. Most of the time that greeting is interrupted by patchouli, but that's okay. Cuddle. I mean, I don't really have anything else to say about this, but just don't forget you have a lifelong cuddle partner. Take advantage of it. Guys, there's so much more I could say, but I'm gonna leave it there. Let me know how you flirt with your mate and keep the fire alive. And if you're not in a relationship, have you heard of any of these tips or any other tips before? Thanks guys for watching. Subscribe, like, and comment, and I'll catch you next time. Bye.